Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today I got a ton going on at the homestead. You see right here, over here, I just cleared out my hibiscus from right back there. I'm actually going to leave that row of hibiscus over there for the time being because I got to process all of this hibiscus. I made some tea with it earlier this year, and it was phenomenal. So I gotta take care of these before I pull up all of those over there. I will be saving seeds from some of these as well, so that way I have seeds for next year to do what I gotta do. I gotta get my carrots out. I have got to get my carrots out. So I have a raised bed back there behind the greenhouse that I'm going to be prepping for my carrots. Before that, obviously, I got to get everything cleared out of it. I'm going to be doing some flame weeding over there with that. This area right here where you see the T-posts at is going to be where I put my collards. My collards are going through there. All of this is on drip irrigation, but if you look back there where the morning glories are, I do have an overhead sprinkler if I need it, and I will need it for that carrot bed over there. So what I typically do if I have something that needs overhead and it's in this drip area, I will turn off the drip valves at the beginning of those so they only get one watering, you know, when they need it. I got to clear out all this whole area right here, but I'm not particularly worried about all of that today. If I can get the carrot bed cleared and this area right here where these T-posts are, if I can get that cleared, I'll be in really good shape. So come along with me. I'm going to start with clearing out that bed back there with the flame weeder. Real quick, I wanted to show you my sweet potatoes. I should be digging those here soon, but they have taken over this hillside over here, which I do not mind at all, because that way I didn't have to really cut it too much. I don't like cutting this hill. It's on a pretty good little slant there. You probably can't see it on the computer or on the video, but yeah, that's really I'm looking forward to pulling some sweet potatoes. All right, well, sorry you missed the good part. I've burned all the weeds off and the camera had turned off. But I love doing that because it's so quick. And this will go into the compost. Nothing really goes to waste on the homestead. Keep my compost pretty hot, so. Ooh. Grab the hot piece right there. All right, well, now I got to get some soil in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to pull some soil from one of my garden beds back there to hopefully top this off. If not, I got some bag compost over there that I might use to finish it off. But I'm turning that garden back there into a all in-ground garden back there. So I got three raised beds back there. I don't need them. Which there's plenty of soil in those to fill this, I believe. So let's get to work on that.
All right, so we're up here in the Oura garden, as I call it. Formerly known as the pasture garden. These are the three beds that I'm going to clear out. I'm going to take them apart and I'll reuse that lumber somewhere else.
Joker back in here. Oh, yeah, I'll be fine. Get it over a little bit of this grass out, but I ain't too worried about it. All my beds end up with this grass in it, no matter if I add it to it or not. Just have to keep up on it. Sweat equity today. Sometimes when you don't have actual equity, meaning money, you have to offset it with some sweat equity. It would have been nice to just go out and buy more soil and dump it in here, but unfortunately, that is not the case. So, I had to rob from Peter to pay Paul. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. Alright, so these are the carrots that I'm gonna grow this year. We got Danvers, Purple Elite, which is my favorite, Yellow Bunch, Envy Carrot, and Bolero Carrot. This is a really good one too. I'm gonna plant one row of each. So I'll do 5 rows down through here, 1 row of each, and pretty simple, easy process. I don't lay no string or do anything like that because it's not that deep. So I just run my stick down through here, just like that. This is about the middle. I need one in the middle of that. And then I'll go one row right up against the edge right here. And then I'll do one row right in the middle of those. There we go. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. And then old Mr. Haas over there at Haas Tools, he showed me a cool way to do carrots, is to just cut that in, that corner right there, And then just tap the seeds out as you go. So I found that that works really, really good. And I left my knife, so I'll be right back. All right, so I had my scissors inside of the greenhouse right here. So I just went and grabbed those. Make sure there's none up there. And then just snip the end of it off like that. So, all right, and I know that's enough. Hopefully it's not too much. Let me bring you down here with you so you can see what I'm doing. To do is to water this in real good. A lot of people will cover this with cardboard and, you know, just to keep the moisture in and whatnot, and I don't find it that difficult. I water it every day, probably two times a day. This time of year it doesn't get too hot, so all this should germinate real good. I sometimes plant my carrots in September. This year I'm planting in October. I think today's October 9th. So I waited about 2 weeks longer than I normally do. And I think it's going to really pay off. Even though last year, if you look at my harvest from last year, I'll put it up on the screen for you. I had a great harvest, and this harvest only shows the final harvest. I harvested all throughout the winter and spring before that as well. So I definitely had a really great crop of carrots, and I only used a bed this size and a bed this size, but a little bit wider, or the 1 foot wider. So I had two beds of carrots last year, and they produced greatly. All right, well, that's my process on planting carrots. A couple things that you need to keep in mind. You have to have loose soil and no rocks, nothing that's going to impact the carrot as it goes down. You need well-draining soil, but you also, at the top right here, you kind of need some soil that's going to hold some moisture, unless you want to cover it with a with cardboard or whatnot. Some people cover it with a regular board, you know, just a regular piece of wood they cover it with, and then they look under it to see when a carrot is germinating, and once one's germinating, they take it off. I hear that works really, really well, but I mean, I homestead full time, so I can be here. So I don't think that, me having the water every day, a couple times a day, is not that big of a deal. So we'll keep showing you the progress on this right here. I still got to finish clearing off the garden here behind you. I'll probably get on that tomorrow. Probably not going to film it, but yeah. So I don't know how much the camera caught because it kept cutting off on me, but you should have got to see me get some of the soil from the other garden back there and flame weed that garden, the raised beds back there. And other than that, and you got to see me plant my carrots right here. I still have a ton of carrots left, so I'll find another spot. Plant them sometime this week as well. But I appreciate you watching. Thanks for hanging in this long. If you like the video, please hit like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.